Hey! So I caught just the tail end of it. Apologize, guys, I was flying the drone, but I figured I'd capture. The sun just dropped, it's beautiful. Gorgeous sunset. Let me put it on the other camera. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it was just there a minute ago and it had some brilliant color to those clouds. It was awesome. Pretty cool. Yeah, it's beautiful. I'm actually up on top of the grain bin. I better get to my spot still last. Did I get my combine fixed? No, we didn't. We're waiting on parts. Won't be here till Monday. Yeah, it's beautiful. I was flying the drone around catching some video running the truck down the road, and both my batteries ran out. I barely eked out a little bit of video, but yeah, pretty real beautiful. I'm sure it absolutely does not do it justice on your screen, but anyway. My dad's down there somewhere. He's unloading that truck right there. We just moved to these bins. We are way up north over the hill, about 5 miles that way. And we just finished topping all the bins off up there with winter wheat. And so now we're moving down to our main storage here next to our farm, which is right over here. Oh man, beautiful. I do have a drone to get some good images. Only problem with drones is when they run out of battery, they're no good. So, yeah, I'm sitting up on top of this thing. As you can see, this lid doesn't feel that, that's dirty, but I haven't fallen yet, so I guess I'm good. What time is it? I don't even know. It's 9:11. 9:11. I'm gonna get down one step. Okay. I don't know how high this is. I'm probably up there. Oh, I gotta be 25, 30 feet. Something like that. Yeah, I need a shower. And I need to change a shirt. It's just about to the end there. When they start getting little holes randomly everywhere, I think it's lived its life. So I'm trying to use it the last leg, but one of these days I'm just gonna take it off. It's gonna rip in like 4 pieces, then I'll know it's time to turn it into a rag. How far am I from Saskatchewan? 5 hours, something like that. About 5 hours. Can you give me a shirt? Hey, if you're willing to give the shirt off your back, you're a good man. So, yeah. I know. Sometimes I do pay attention to chat. Today I'm not driving anything, or at least right now I'm not, so I can actually read what you guys are saying. Hello from Utah, California. So we have one combine broke down. That's why I'm up here, actually. Otherwise, I'd be in a combine or something. And it's not going to get fixed till probably Monday. But the other one's in the field right now. My brother's just finishing up a field up north. And then we only have about 100 acres left of winter wheat, and we're done. And then spring wheat next week. What size is my shirt? I wear large. Cincinnati. Jeremy Paz. Shout out to you, buddy. It's amazing how many Michigan people are on here. I actually know a lot of Michigan guys and girls. What system to unload your trucks? Well, if you guys bear with me, I'll climb down this grain bin without getting slipping and falling. There's no cage on these ladders. But there's a drive over deck right here. The truck drives across it, unloads the hopper, and that conveyor takes it up into the auger. And then the auger takes it up and drops it in the bin. So, yes, the sunset does show the beauty of creation. I just have a hard time sitting here looking at just the color that is shining off these clouds. And to think that our ability to even see color just came from nothing. So, pretty awesome. Have you ever ran a John Deere skid steer with tracks? I have not. We've got one of tires, but I'll send you a cool shirt. Well, that'd be cool, Dale. I got lots of shirts, but I'm always okay for freebies. They're going to Precision Drill. Yeah, Precision Drills would be nice. I hear they're an absolute headache, though, after they get a few hours on them, and all the hydraulics have issues. But our problem is our big buds aren't set up for them. We'd have to upgrade our hydraulic pumps and coolers and all that stuff. They take, I've heard, as much as 100 gallons a minute flow to run a Precision. Oops, my dad's taking off. You guys can watch this. Let's see here. Here he goes. What's wrong with the combine? Basically, the hydrostatic drive motor, the bolts came loose on it and it began to wobble inside the transmission, which then wore out the splines inside of a collar inside the transmission. So we have to buy a new collar. And the funny thing is, guess what? That part is in Regina, up in Canada. So that's why it's not gonna be until Monday. So as long as the Canadians get her shipped off pretty quick, we'll be good to go. On spot grain bin builders here watching you live. Nice. This is also kind of our iron pile junkyard area. You can see we had a bunch of scrap thieves when iron prices hit the roof. And that was a few years ago. And they'd come in the night with trailers and they'd load up all your old cars and tractors and combines and anything you had laying out in the farm. We've had equipment laying out in spots for, you know, eons. It's worn out and they'd steal them. So we went around one day and loaded up all of our tractors and iron and everything that's just worthless but has value in iron and put it in a big pile. Does your dad not get mad for me slacking? Well, right now he won't because there's nothing going on. I mean, we only have one combine running. There's a truck up north with the combine way up there. So he's just gonna fill that truck and call it quit. So we're pretty much off for the night. What size of grain bins? These are around 8,000 bushels. There's eight of them, but we need more. My brother is a few miles north. He's over the hill up there. I drive up there, but cell phone service drops off because there's kind of a hill at this ridge up here. That's why I haven't been going live at all. Is the hydro broke? No, the hydrostatic drive is not broke, thank God, because I imagine that motor would run at least 10 grand. Maybe not, but the splines on the motor seem to be good, so we lucked out. But the collar, the geared shaft that we're getting with the spline collar on it is $600 plus shipping, and then we have to get a bearing and some other stuff too. So we'll still have probably a grand into it. Drove through your place with our big butt. Oh, nice. Yeah, you guys did. I hear you guys are rolling. I need to come and go live on Wonkin Farms. That's an operation you guys would like. They run some nice machines. Put ours to shame. Heck yeah. Yeah, I need to do a video. Welker Farms and Wonkin Farms. They're friends of ours, and they got a nice operation, and it'd be fun. They got a bunch of big buds, too. In fact, they have like three or four of them total, I think, if you add them all up. Take the muffler off the big bud. I bet that's all right. Okay, I got to figure out how to get down from this thing. Okay. So, these grain bins are probably pretty dangerous. I've always wanted to run and jump the other side and see if I can make it across, but I've never done it. I'm not going to do it today. But they probably say you need two hands and both legs to get down this thing, but I'm going to be a rebel tonight, so bear with me as I climb down this bin here. Yeah, it's just a little drop. Not that bad. All right. As long as you keep one hand on at all times. I'm actually surprised not more people are injured by falling off green bins. There's been some days where it's blowing 40, 50 miles an hour and you're trying to climb up these things. And, yeah. So, anyways. Do we have fungicide? We don't really, actually. We didn't get enough rain this year to have any fungus issues that we know of. So, yeah, we don't really have any fungicide. Please don't fall. We don't need to. Yeah, you know what happens if people fall when they go live? Then it ends up on the Drudge Report. Because anymore, people seem to do the dumbest things on live, which I probably just did. Here's our drive over deck. This is that I was telling you about. I had a video earlier, but you drive across, obviously, like this. My focus isn't on. And then when you're across, there's a lever right here, and you grab it, you flip it over, and it folds these shields up, help funnel the weed in. And drops over here, goes into a twin auger, which then goes into one big 13-inch auger, and that drops it into this compartment, which then takes it on up that auger. So that's a little deal, but it's really nice. We love running semis. It makes beats tandems any day. If your farm can handle them, that is. We got nice, pretty flat ground and decent county roads, and so we can handle running semis. Am I younger or older than my brother? Can you guess? Yes, that is a 7140. It's actually a pretty good running track. It's got a lot of hours on it. Have we had a 2188? Yes, we had two. Just a couple years ago, actually. What was that, like 5 years ago? We had two 2188s, and we traded them off for the 25s. We farm around 10,000 acres total, outside of Shelby, Montana. Younger. Sorry, I'm older, actually. Everyone always thinks he's older than me. No, but we're close. We're only a year apart. Well, 15 months or something like that. So, just finished building an 87-foot-high grain bin. Wow. That's impressive. They probably are about to. I think my pickup's dying. Nope, there we go. This is an 88 or an 89 Chevy 3/4 ton with a 454 in it. And it is hailed. It's seen better days. We got it really cheap. I kind of wish we didn't get it because I put so much time rebuilding it and money that we could have been better off just buying a different pickup. But it gets us around. Here's some of our old guys. That's a TD18 International dozer. And we took the engine out of that combine and modified it to mount up to the transmission in that bulldozer. It runs pretty good. The only problem is it's still got a cable blade hoist on it, and the clutch packs are going out, and it's, doesn't really do that much work. So we don't really run it much anymore, but it's fun to crush cars with, and a lot of those cars have been driven over by that thing, so that's always fun. But that's what I learned to drive combine in. That was my very first combine experience, was in the 7700, and that ran just a few years ago. Oh, both 7700s. This is a turbo and a non-turbo. I think that's a Titan 2. That's what they call this one. Hello from Indiana. So now we just steal stuff off of them when we want them. We're doing projects or whatever, we'll come in here and rip some parts off of them and, I don't know, try to make something, so. Yeah, and here's a real oldie. This is probably what those are gonna look like in a couple years. Hopefully not. That's an old John Deere of some kind. It's a combine, I don't know what model that is. But that girl is old. We have an 8820. Oh wow, nice. What's up, everyone? Farm graveyard. Yeah, I don't even know I'm showing you all this stuff. This is all our, that's an old spray pickup we used to use. Old baler when we had horses. That pickup runs fine, but the mice ate the wiring harness out of it, and we haven't taken time to fix it. We got it pretty much free though, so. Old pickups, old service truck. That used to be our old water truck and grain truck. I want to turn that thing into a rat rod someday. I'm thinking of Cummins. I just got to find a door for it. What is the highest hour tractor? You know, our big buds are pushing 10,000 to 12,000 hours. So I bet we've got, yeah, we've got a bud with at least 12,000 hours on it. Could be more. There's a nice tire pile. Here's our engine graveyard. As you can see, we've got anything from a V8 John Deere that came out of that loader, to a 404 John Deere, to a TD18 engine, a bunch of 350 blocks, 318s. 305s. This is out of an Oldsmobile. And right here is the second engine out of that big bud, the first big bud, the series one that we restored. This is the engine that was in it. It wasn't worth anything because it's not a big cam. You can't tune them up anymore. So we put it here. And it's still got the transmission on it too. And that transmission actually still works, but it's an old gear transmission. Doesn't have the helical gears, at least that are as efficient as the new one. So it's real noisy. So poor thing just sits here now. But it was running really bad when we took it out. And that's the bud that has an N14 in it now. So yeah, here's my ride. She's a beaut. But if it gets you from A to B, I guess that's all that matters. So, and that's an iron pile. That's where we throw a lot of our mixed iron. And we're constantly digging through that, finding stuff for projects and all kinds of goodies. So, okay. Do we have anything left with DEF? We have no equipment with the DEF, fortunately. I know eventually that's gonna change, but for right now, we're not running anything with urea injection, which is really nice. I think our newest machine would be our Apache sprayer, and that's a 2010 or 11. Might be, I think it's a 2010. And that was just before they started doing the DEF. I think they did 2 years later, and then they started putting DEF in. Do I watch Big Tractor Power? Yeah, I do. How's the baby? The baby's doing great. She's growing. Yep. Constantly growing. She's a cutie. I don't get to spend a lot of time with her right now, so I'm on live stream with you guys. Is an automatic nine? Yeah, Big Buds, they did make some with power shifts. And we have one of those too, that's a power shift. So, yeah, she's doing well. Let's see here. So anyways, yeah, we're just about done with winter wheat. Tomorrow we'll be done. And then all of our spring wheat's all around here. And it's gonna be hit and miss. Some of it is absolutely toast. And some of it's gonna probably yield a decent amount. But overall, I think we're gonna be, I don't know. I can't predict anything until we get into it. But we'll find out soon enough what our spring wheat runs out to be. What kind of sense do you guys have in USA for Alberta? Is this considered texting and driving? I don't think they have anything against live streaming and driving, do they? Because if they do, I'm breaking some serious rules right now. I'm actually right next to our lentil crop. I'll show you guys what our lentils look like right now. I don't think they're too pretty. We don't really know a lot about lentils. We've never grown them before. It's our first year. And they've really taken a beating through this drought that we've had, so we're not expecting very good yields out of them, but you never know, we might get lucky. Our combine blue, get unloading, oh no, that's not good. Ugh. It's distracted driving, okay, yeah, you're right. That's right. 12,000 hours times 44 is 5,280,000 miles, wow. Okay, here. Flip this around. It's getting darker, but I think the camera will adjust. Here's our lentils. And I'll find a pod or two. There. And they're starting to turn brown on the leaves. I think they're just running out of water. I'm hopeful they'll yield better than what we're expecting, but I bet you it's not going to run more than 5 to 10 bushel, if that, which will probably just about pay for the cost of putting it in. But you never know. There's some of the pods, right there. If you open these up, I can do it with one hand. Oh, there's a lentil right there. You see that? Is it focusing on it? Nope, not very well. So who knows? There could be more here than we think, but we're gonna wear our headers out trying to cut it. A good lentil crop is 20 to 30 if they don't run that great. Yeah, well, I don't think this is gonna make 20. That'd be awesome if it did. It looked good. It had the potential, just ran out of water. Can you show us the big buds? I suppose I could drive over there. It wouldn't be too bad. To buy a truck in Idaho, oh yeah, very nice. We actually had some visitors from British Columbia outside of Vancouver come down and ride on the combine with us. It was fun. Here's some of our spring wheat that, it looks like a nice spring wheat crop, but these heads, they're not filling out. There's like nothing in them. You thresh them out. Oops, well, blew all that off. The kernels are just little teeny shriveled things. So it's really hard to say. This field's got problems though. We had some samples sent in and they said there's root rot. No, we didn't inoculate anything. Actually, I take that back. We did inoculate everything. I thought you said desiccate. No, we inoculated all of it. Yeah, we inoculated all the peas. We put down, actually, we had a lot of leftover urea. So we put down like 30 some pounds of urea with it. So it was beautiful. I mean, I think it really had a potential of a good, pretty good lentil crop. If it would have gotten rain, I bet you it would have pushed 15, 20 bushels, no problem. This is good ground that's on, but you can't grow stuff if it doesn't rain. You can have our rain. It's been nonstop. Oh, I'd love to have your rain. So you guys are around the buds of death, or close to death. You know, the buds, I don't know. It's hard to say. I think we love them, and as long as they're doing our job that we want them to do, we'll keep running them. And right now, the air drills that we use, the buds are more than sufficient to pull them. They've got horsepower for future size increase, so if we go to a bigger, like an 80-some foot air drill, or even, you know, 65, 70, whatever they run, we'll have the horsepower to pull them. So that's something we don't have to buy, and we can save hundreds of thousands of dollars not upgrading them. And let's just say we have to put $20,000 in each big bud for a new hydraulic system to be able to handle an 80-some foot air drill with precision. Well, that's $20,000. Well, what does it cost to get into a nice tractor that can pull a precision drill? $400,000 to half million. So it's kind of a no-brainer. Why upgrade? We own them, they're nostalgic, they're comfortable, and they're really easy to work on. So that's why we'll probably keep running them. Do you put lime in your fields? No, we don't put any lime. We do phosphorus and a little bit of sulfur, but no lime. Lime would actually probably be good. Big buds for life. How much horsepower are big buds? Well, the one I'm about to drive by in a minute here is, we actually don't know. It's kind of a mystery. It's supposed to be rated at 525 horsepower, but when we had it taken in to have some work done at Big Equipment, kind of the original factory of Big Buds, the mechanic that drove it said it's tuned way up, and so he figured it was somewhere around 600 or more. We don't really know. I'm sure there's a way you can find out with these 1150 Cummins by looking at the fuel pump and what it's set at, but there's a good chance it's probably 600 or more, and it lets you know it's powerful, and it snorts too. It blows black coal, or rolls coal. Black smoke all over the place, so she's actually gonna get work tomorrow, and I might have a video of that. If you look closely here, she's all hooked up. What's my favorite brand of tractor? Well, besides Big Bud, probably Case. All right, we'll do a quick walk around here. I probably should call it a night and shower because I've been at this all day. Okay. Do we guys allow visitors? Yeah, we do. I don't know how we'd handle a ton of visitors, but yeah, I mean, as long as we're not really busy at the moment. So I just did some maintenance on this the plow. That's a coil packer right there. This is 57, actually, no, 60 feet, I think. Start it. you know, tomorrow. She'll get the drive tomorrow. So we've got some CRP ground that we sprayed out and it needs worked. So this is the beast that's gonna do it. This thing needs a paint job. And that's probably this winter. I think we're gonna go through this one next. It doesn't need a lot of mechanical work done, but the cab and the paint and the decals all need spiffed up. Get these rims nice and white, and yeah, it'll be really nice. Yeah, she's a sweet tractor. It's a beast. It's fun to have all three. I wish we had the fourth series four, but we haven't got to the point where we're ready to get another tractor yet. So she's set up with a Trimble 500. Actually, no, that's not a 500. Is that a 500 or is that a 250? I think that's a 500. And, yeah, there's the power shift right there. It's getting dark in here. Can't even focus. Come on, buddy. You can do it. Focus. There's only one setting for it. Okay. How long are you going to go live stream for? I don't know. For a while. That's a good question. We'll start her tomorrow. Do I like Fords? Yeah, I do like Fords. Fords are good. We don't have a lot of them. Not that we don't like them, though there were a number of years that Ford kind of dropped the ball with some of their pickups, but overall, Fords are good pickups. What size of tires does she have? Oh, I don't know. I should know. Actually, I'll tell you in a second here, because these combines use the same tires. Let's see here. How fast does it go down the road? Top speed's a little over 20. I've gone about 25 downhill. But I bet you full throttle, it probably runs about 22, 23. So it is 800/65R32. And that's a Firestone, so that's what's on the bud. Yep, they do have heat and air conditioning. Definitely have air conditioning. This is the combine that's broke. Yeah, it wasn't a good day for it yesterday. Two things broke, actually. Chaffer cracked in two. So we fixed that, took it out to the field, and it ran most of the day. And then the hydrostatic drive, which it's getting dark. I don't think you guys can even see that. It's all apart right now, so we're waiting for parts. When we get parts, we'll get that fixed up and get her to work again because we need it for spring wheat. So we've got 2,700 acres of spring wheat to do. Here's the piece that's $600 for just this. And I bet this bearing is another 100 at least. And then there's a little sleeve in there that we have to get as well. So I bet you there's $800 here for that thing, but can't run without it. But all the splines on the inside ripped out. It shredded all of them. And this is just a housing that it goes inside of. Why is your internet at the shop worse than out of the field? Is it coming in kind of bad? I'm actually, I'm not on Wi-Fi. I'm still on cell phone right now. Wi-Fi is good, but there's pockets of it here. And so sometimes I'll hit a nice pocket. Sometimes I won't. So I'm on cell phone right now. How many acres do we have? We farm around 10,000. Case quad tracks are very nice. Do you ever fly a plane anymore? I should. I'm still current right now. My biennial's up in October, but I just haven't had time, and when I do have time, I always end up doing something else. But I really need to go up. I need to fly. It's kind of one of those dilemmas. Do I want to keep my license and keep paying insurance and cost per hour to just buzz around the farm, or do I want to spend that money somewhere else? So I don't know. I went to school to do that, so it's kind of hard to give it up. Watching from Tennessee, awesome. What other tractors do we have? We got all kinds of tractors. What other tractors? Let's see, New Hollands, Tennessee. Use a grain cart or just a semi? Just the semis. Right now, they're doing great. There could be a day we might get a grain cart, but for now, our semis, you know, the fields are nice. And hey, it's AJ. The semis, they do it, and we're able to not have another man out in the field. And so far, but if we get more combines, though, we'll probably have to figure out getting something, whether it be another truck or a grain cart. Hot and dry Nebraska. I feel your pain. Don't worry, Corey. It's hot and dry here, too. And I got a buddy, too, on Facebook. He's a kind of a fan of the channel. He's actually one of the first fans, and he's been making videos. And he's got a channel, too, and he wanted me to give him a shout-out. So his channel name's The Diesel Weasel. The Diesel Weasel. And he's got some fun videos, so you should check him out. Does your bud have a PTO? It does not. Does not have a PTO drive. I wish it did. That'd be awesome. How many combines do we have? Two. 225/88. Been getting regular rain in Colorado. Wow, that's awesome. How many miles on the Pete? Both the Petes have over 1 million miles. They've been used. But they've also been overhauled and upgraded over the years. We haven't owned them for that much. We've probably only had them for, I don't know, probably 20,000 miles at most. We don't put a lot of miles on them. It's just hard miles. So, but, yeah. Where'd my comments go? Nope. There we go. Use green. Oh, I'm way off. Sorry, comments are off here. Okay. Watch from Idaho. Very nice. Oh, wow. It's really moving now. it's going so fast I can't keep up. How come we don't irrigate during low rain? We don't have access to water. We'd irrigate if we could, but we don't have any water access, so we rely on just the rain. Good job on your videos. Thank you. I appreciate it. I've been really disappointed this harvest so far. It's just been so dry. We have no storms. The weather's been nice for farming, but the skies are so clear, we have no clouds. And then the fires in Montana are burning so much that there's a haze all around. And we've been short a person and on and off. So what I'm trying to get at is basically I haven't been able to hardly film. And there hasn't been any really cool moments to film. So I don't think I'm going to be able to get a nice farming video this year. But I'm capturing as much as I can. I got some good stuff today, so we'll see what I get. But, and my name is Nick. I think I saw someone there. Yeah. Nick, how did our peas do? Our peas ran, you know, spots were up to 40. Some of the recrop was down in the lower 20s. So we probably averaged out about 30, which is pretty good. We're happy with that. Have you all of your semis always been farm trucks? No, actually, most of our trucks were at one point in time road trucks. Our Blue Pete was a California garbage truck. So that's why it was a good truck, because it had the state of California keeping up on it. And I wonder if I can switch over real quick here. Okay, I just switched to Wi-Fi. I've got better signal with that. Okay. All right, what's going on here? Oh boy, I can't keep up with everything. Are you the biggest farm in Shelby? You know, if we were just right outside of Shelby, one of the bigger farms, there's some big farms around though. I'd say we're pretty average. There's some definitely some larger farms and some smaller farms, but overall we're probably on the bigger side. But you don't go very far and there's farms that just make us look like little hobby farms, especially in Canada. There's a few across the border that are just massive farms. Do we use contractors? Sometimes. What do you usually grow? Wheat. We grow peas, lentils this year, but that's kind of an experiment. Start the big bud, please. I'm your biggest fan. Tomorrow. I'll start it tomorrow. How about that? I need to get a video of that thing. I can't start it tonight. People are going to bed. Thing's noisy. We have 3 big buds. 3 or 4 lockers. No, they don't have 3-way lockers. I think it's only 2-way. It only locks up 2 wheels. I wish we had lockers all around. It'd been nice. We've gotten them stuck in the snow quite a bit. What happened to the combine saw it being towed? The hydrostatic drive motor, there's 4 bolts that hold it on, and they got loose, and it started to wobble. At least this is what we think happened. And when it wobbled, it wore out the splines inside the transmission and then eventually ripped them all out. So we have to get a new collar, and we're waiting it on order. So it's just sitting right over here, actually. And the parts should be here Monday, and we'll get her reeling again, which is actually perfect because we're just finishing up our winter wheat right now. So we'll have that done tomorrow with the other combine. And then the spring wheat, when we get that fixed, should be ready to go. So, yeah. You going to live stream tomorrow? I could. I was actually thinking about it. Where I'll be, I'll probably have good cell phone service. So, yeah, I was thinking. I had it held off live streaming yesterday and today because I've been out of service or really bad. Please stream tomorrow. Okay, I could do that for you guys. How's the baby? The baby's doing great. Thanks for asking. Yeah, she's a cutie. Hopefully sleeping right now. that could be why they got loose. Another reason why the bolts got loose on that hydrostatic drive is because we took it off last year, and maybe we didn't tighten them tight enough, which is probably what happened. One of the brakes got locked up on it and burnt up the brake and basically cooked the transmission and got it super hot. It was boiling. So we had it taken off last year. We took it off, had it rebuilt. Not new gears or anything, just all the seals and gaskets rebuilt, everything that was rubber. Put it all back together again, and I bet you we just didn't tighten that motor well strong enough, so it's kind of unfortunate. The weather is really nice right now. It's probably 85 degrees out, no wind. It's really nice. Loctite's probably a good idea. Yeah, actually, I bet we're going to now. $1,000 lesson learned. Could you smell the hydro when it went? Not this time. Last year, yes. There was they could just tell the combine was underpowered and Could figure out what was going on. Well, it's underpowered when the brake's stuck on. But how much are we selling our wheat for? Well, it's not really us selling it. It's more how much are people willing to buy it for, the market. And right now the market for spring wheat around this area is like $5.50. No, sorry, take that back. My bad. $7.50. It was $5.50. It's $7.50 right now, and I think winter wheat is $5.40 or something like that. So hopefully it'll go up some more. That'd be nice. It's gone up a bunch, but it did drop a little bit. So we're hanging on to it and hopefully find a nice rain. How much were the big buds? New, they were like $100,000 to $150,000. When they first came out, they were about $50,000. We picked up ours. I don't know what my grandpa paid for his. I really don't. But the last one we got, I think we paid like 50-some thousand for it. But we had to have the transmission rebuilt. It had problems, and that was another 40-some thousand dollars. And then with all the other stuff we've done to it, we probably have over 100,000 in it. So you're looking at 100,000 probably. How is the protein? Protein right now, we don't know. We had some come in at 10.3, and we haven't checked the spring wheat yet, so we don't really know how that's doing. I top-dressed all the winter wheat with UAN, so we were hoping that would do better, but I'm hoping that the protein comes in 11 or better. It should be. All the guys around us seem to be getting good protein, so we're hoping that we get that. Dual axle grain trailers. Dual axle. Why don't you want dual axles, in your opinion? Well, more axles means more tires to repair and replace, and more wheel bearings to go out, and more brakes to fix, but more axles also means more weight you can carry. And we don't drive a lot on paved roads, so we don't really have to worry about weight, but I'm sure a triple axle trailer would be nice. They're just expensive. What does a big bud look like? You don't know what a big bud looks like. It's right over there. Can you see it? That's what it looks like. It's a nice tractor. Family farm. What state are we in? We're in Montana. 300-acre farm. Oh, very nice. 300 acres is quite a bit. North Carolina, very nice. So, I also have something else kind of exciting that you guys, I don't know if any of you watch RFD TV. I actually don't have it myself, but they interviewed me yesterday, and they're going to play some of my videos on one of their shows. I think it's what is the name of the show? I'll have to look again. Anyways, on Monday, so that'd be kind of cool. Yeah, I don't know. I have to find out when exactly. They didn't tell me when it's supposed to air, so I'll go find out. But yeah, I need to check it out. It's pretty cool, though. It's I can't remember the channel. Anyways. Interior. I live on a farm in Wawan. Oh, very nice. Good night from the USA. Good night. Any hired man or just family? Just family until harvest, typically. We had one hired guy. He just had something come up, so he was able to leave for a while. But we usually hire one or two people and go through harvest about 3 weeks, and then it's over. Love the videos. Thank you. I hope to keep making good videos. The tractor pulls. Oh, yeah, they do that, don't they? Let me find the show. Hang on a second. Okay, that doesn't work. I can't minimize this. Sorry, guys. I was going to look up the name of the show that they're going to play it on, and I can't. Good morning, everyone. I love farming. Farming is awesome. Crop duster. I just see crop duster. I don't know what that's about. Big buzz. When you Google it, it has pictures of the tractor. Oh, yeah, I know. I used to have my name Big Bud 450, I think, or Big Bud 350. When I used to play video games online, and everybody thought I was talking about cannabis. So that's the unfortunate part about Big Bud, I think, is they, got that problem. So, but it's actually named after a guy that was like 6'3" or 6'4" or something. He was a real big man, and he was part of the development of Big Bud, so that's why they named it. What kind of toothpaste do I use? Provolone. Provolone? Yes, provolone. Enamel stuff, whatever that's been. Harvest has been great. How many acres of each crop do you have? We had about 1,800 acres in winter wheat, 2,700 acres in spring wheat, 1,000 acres in peas, and 120 acres of lentils. So right now we're down to spring wheat and lentils. Ever entertain the idea of putting in a flathead V8 or Ford in and changing out the gears for faster ones? Just fun. Yeah, that would be fun. Do you hunt? I do hunt. I hunt every year. I should probably. Let's see here. Instagram. Okay, Instagram. I actually don't use Instagram. I don't know why. I never got into that. So, what kind of peas? Yellow peas. They're Montecs. They seem to be doing pretty good out here. We like them. We should do a tug of war. I've actually always wanted to hook the buds together and do a tug of war. But I've actually always wanted to take our 600 bud and hook it up to a quad track. But I'm kind of fearful that the quad track would outpull the buds, so I don't know if I want to do that. But that'd be a video to watch. The problem is, I got to find someone at the quad track who's willing to do that. There's a lot of pride online for that one. But you never know, it might happen someday. Don't do it, it's hard on the tractors. Yeah, I know. Spinning tires is never good. If you put them in a real low gear and you're in some soft soil, you know, it's not too bad, but it's not good, especially when they start to hop. Have animals or corn? We have neither, actually. Well, we've got animals. We've got chickens and dogs and cats, but no, we don't have any livestock, whether it be pigs or cows or anything. How tall am I? I'm 5'11". Well, I suppose, guys, I probably better go. It's getting late, as you can see. It's a little dark out here. Let me get some sleep so I can start the day tomorrow and do this all over again. How much does a big bud cost? They can be anywhere from $100,000 to $200,000, depending on how nice condition they are. So, all right, everyone. Take care. Have a good evening. God bless, and we'll catch you guys later. I'm sure I'll be on sometime here, and I'll keep trying to film and then hopefully get a nice video one of these days. So, there'll be more nice videos, and when I get time, I'll start editing some stuff. So, all right. Take care, everyone. Good night. Thank you.